Good evening. I hope everybody had a good day today. Today is Cinco de Mayo, and in our house, we decided today that we were going to kind of make that a celebration day. We were going to make some tacos today and just have some Mexican dinner. And it got me to thinking about it when we were talking about it this morning and seeing what we had in the house to make about traditions. And traditions are very important to families and to communities and to our nation. And they're kind of fun because they're things that have happened that were started way back when maybe and have been handed down from generation to generation. And during this time when we've all been home, some of our traditions have not been able to happen. Like Easter, when we weren't able to go to church or have Easter egg hunts or some of those things that we enjoy doing during Easter. And so I know in our house, we've tried to kind of compromise and come up with some traditions that maybe were things that we haven't done before, but were kind of fun to do while we were stuck inside. So it just got me thinking about that. And we did some things at Easter that I've done. I made a bread that my mom always made when I was growing up, but we tried some new things like making a rabbit cake out of a carrot cake. So just some fun things like that. So today we decided we'd try that with Cinco de Mayo also. And so it got me thinking about this Bible verse that's in Deuteronomy chapter 6, verse 7. And this is right at the beginning of when God is giving the laws to Moses. And he's already told him that we should love him with our whole heart and our whole mind and our whole being. And this comes right after that. It says, recite them to your children and talk about them when you are at home and when you are away and when you lie down and when you rise. So here he's talking about the law, and he's talking about the parents teaching their children the law of God. And our traditions are kind of like that. The parents teach it to the children, and then when the children get big, they teach it to their children, and it keeps going generation after generation. And our faith is like that too. And we should teach our faith just like we teach our other traditions. We teach our children about God and about Jesus. We read to them from the Bible. We teach them to pray and all those things, taking them to church, taking them to Sunday school. And I'm sure your parents have done that for you. And someday when you grow up, you're going to do it for your children. But it's something that God wants us to do. And he told us about it way back in the Old Testament. So it's kind of fun that thousands of years ago, our traditions in the church started. So let us pray. Dear Father in heaven, thank you for today and this time to come together. Thank you for traditions, family traditions, church traditions, community traditions, and even national traditions. Help us to remember how these traditions link us to the past and to the future. Thank you for the reminder today that the most important tradition is worshiping you every day. Amen. So I hope you have a great evening tonight, and we will see you tomorrow. Sleep tight. Get a good night's rest.